Hi everyone, this is Satyam and welcome back to my channel. So today's video is all about when to change the gears. So in my previous video, I told you how to swiftly change the gears. And in today's video, I'm going to tell you like when and at what speed you should change the gear. So this video is going to be really helpful for all the beginners who are learning to drive. And this is a much requested video. Many of you have commented in the comment section to make a video on when to change the gears. So yeah, here it is. And lately I have noticed that many of the beginners, what they do, they really get confused as to when to change the gears. They do not have a perfect idea. And in that case, what they do, they either continue driving on one particular gear or they forget to change the gear at all. Or they wait for the instructor to tell them, like, now you have to change the gear. And you know, such kind of dependency on the instructor to know like when to change the gear will never give you a clear picture on your own, like when a gear has to be changed. And such kind of a clear picture has to be borne clearly in mind. You should have your own judgment that now I have to change the gear in order to learn driving perfectly. So for that, I thought like I should clear this doubt for once and for all and tell you like this is the particular speed at which this gear should be maintained. This is the particular speed, this gear. So once you have that idea, you will be able to change the gears perfectly, and moreover, you'll be able to change the gears without looking on the dashboard or on the gearbox. And this is very much important, because while changing the gears, we don't look on the gearbox or the dashboard. It has to be judged on your own, and then according to that judgment you have to keep on driving. So yeah, this is all about today's video. And moreover, before getting on to that point, like what is the different speed ranges, I want to tell you when to change the gear depends on 6 things. First of all, on the style of driving of the driver. Second thing is that what is the total load in the car. And moreover, the gear change differs from car to car. And in what kind of traffic are you driving? And it also depends whether you are driving uphill or whether you are driving downhill. So these are the total 6 points on which when to change the gears depend. And now let's get quickly into the video. Okay. Now, in order to learn about the range of speed and when to change the gear, we should first of all start our car. And as I have told you in my previous videos, so in order to start the car, first of all, we have to make sure the gear is in neutral position. So this is the neutral position. When you turn it right, it comes back to the central position. When we turn it towards the left, it comes back to the central position. That means this is a neutral position. Now, once the gear is in neutral position, we'll press the clutch and then we start our car. Once the car has been started, now we will change the gear from the neutral position to the first position. We have taken the first gear, and accordingly we'll start leaving the clutch and press the accelerator simultaneously, and our car will begin moving. Now, once we attain the speed of 20 km per hour, what we'll do, we'll change the gear from the first position to the second position. That means we'll press the clutch again and change the gear from 1 to 2. Now again we'll release our leg from the clutch and then start pressing the accelerator. And once we'll attain a speed of 25 to 30 kilometers, we will change the gear again from the second position to the third position. For that, again, we will press the clutch, and from the second position here, we will bring it to the third position. That is, we'll take the gear from the second to the third. We'll press the clutch again, and then we'll take it to the third gear. Now, again, we'll start releasing the clutch and press the accelerator. And once we have crossed the speed of 40 km per hour, then we'll change from third to the fourth gear. For that, again, we'll press the clutch and we will bring the gear to the fourth position. Now, we'll further release the clutch and press the accelerator. Once the speed will cross a speed limit of 50 to 55 km, we'll take this gear
from the 4th to the 5th position. So for that again, we'll press the clutch and we will take the gear to the 5th position. This is the 5th position. Again, we'll swiftly release the leg from the clutch and press the accelerator and drive at a speed higher above 55 to 60 kilometers and above. So we'll drive at 5th gear. So this is the speed range at which these particular gears should be maintained. So for the first position, for the first gear, you have to maintain the speed of 0 to 20 km per hour. For the second gear, the speed should cross 20 km per hour, and from 20 to 25 to 30 km per hour should be on second gear. And once you cross the 30 km per hour mark, then change from 2 to 3 and bring it like this. And once you cross the mark of 40 km per hour, change to 4th gear. And once you cross the mark of 50 km per hour, then you bring it to 5th. So this is the 5th position. So this is how the gear should be changed at respective speed. So now you understood what should be the approximate range at which these particular gears should be maintained. Now, the common question that can come to your mind is that what will happen if we maintain a higher speed at a lower gear? Like suppose, for example, if we are driving at third gear and suddenly we cross the limit of 40 km per hour and start driving at 50 km per hour, 60 km, 70 km per hour at the third gear, what will happen? The thing that will happen is the engine of the car will start producing sounds, and you have to identify this sound, and accordingly you have to change the gear from third to fourth position. The sound means that the car is telling you you are driving at a lower gear at a higher speed, and you need to increase the gear also if you are increasing the speed. And this is very much necessary to be taken into account and do it quickly, such that the engine doesn't have to work beyond its capacity at that particular gear, and the fuel efficiency of the car also doesn't get hampered, and the engine also do not get stressed much. Because if you are driving at a higher speed and you have put your car on a lower gear, that means the engine has to work beyond its power, and which is not good for it. Therefore, keep a tap on the gear as per the speed, as well as keep a tap on the noise that comes out of your car. Usually the noise is of the engine, which tells you to take a higher gear. If you are driving on third, you have to move on fourth. If you are driving on fourth, you have to go to the fifth gear. So I hope this is understood. Okay, now the second question that comes to mind is that what will happen if we drive at a lower speed and we forget to change the gear, and we drive at a, higher gear, that means fourth or fifth gear, and we have lowered down the speed to somewhere around 40 kilometers per hour or 30 kilometers per hour. What will happen then? Then your car will start shaking and you'll get a jerk. That means the car is telling you, you haven't changed your gear. You should change your gear from 4th to 3rd or 3rd to 2nd if you have lowered down the speed. So this has to be borne in mind clearly, that your car is going to give you indication. If you drive on a lower gear with a higher speed, the engine will start making noise. If you are driving on a higher gear with a lower speed, the car will start shaking and you'll get a jerk. So these are the indications which you have to understand, and accordingly you have to make changes to the gear quickly. But these are the extreme situations where the car needs to give you indications. You should be smart enough to change the gear appropriately while driving, such that your driving becomes smooth and the car doesn't have to produce extra sounds or give you jerks as an indication to change the gear. So the third thing that I wanted to tell you all is that when we are ascending a slope, when we are driving uphill like this, what we have to do, we have to drive our car on first gear. We should drive our car on first gear or maximum second gear. It should never go up to 3, 4, 5 like on these gears. You won't be able to drive. So what you have to do, you have to take the first gear in order to ascend the slope, because this is the most powerful gear, and here the engine has the on the first gear the engine has the maximum power. So what you have to do, you have to take the first gear while ascending a slope, and then you have to like speed up the car. You have to give accelerator to the car, and once the momentum is gained and you have crossed this portion, and once you come on the flat land, then you change the gears and then you drive normally by accelerating the car. So this is the process of ascending a slope, and be it a small slope or a greater slope. And even if you give the second gear, no, even if you take the car on the second gear, you won't be able to ascend a slope. It will be really difficult for you, and you'll feel that the engine is not getting enough power and your car doesn't have enough energy to ascend up the slope. Therefore, usually, or mostly we can say, so mostly we have to take the first gear in order to ascend the slope. And please remember this. So this is the third thing that I wanted to tell you. Now, one more thing that I want to tell you, that is the fourth thing. Whenever we have to turn the car, or whenever we have to drive across a roundabout, what we have to do, or whenever we have to ascend a slope, in all the three cases, we have to lower down the speed of the car, and then we have to change the gear. If we were driving on fourth, we have to quickly come to third and second, and then we have to turn our car, or we have to drive around a roundabout. And if we have to ascend the slope, as I told you, from third, you have to come to first. So 3, 2, 1, you have to come here, and then you have to try to ascend the slope. So always remember, like whenever the car has to turn, or whenever it has to go around a roundabout like this, or whenever it has to ascend a slope like this, in all these cases, you have to first lower down the speed of the car, and then you have to downshift the gears from fourth to third, third to second, second to first. You cannot turn the car or move around a roundabout or ascend a slope at higher gears or at higher speed. You have to lower down the speed as well as the gears. So please keep this in mind. This is very important.
So I hope you understood today's video and you understood the speed range when the gear has to be changed. So now, if you are a beginner in driving, you will become a pro soon, because now you have understood the speed range at which a particular gear has to be maintained. And moreover, while changing the gear, you don't have to look at the dashboard or at the gearbox in order to change the gear. That has to be an understood thing. Like, you have to develop an understanding within yourself that, okay, I'm driving at this particular speed. Now I need to change the gear from first to second position. Okay, now I have gained up the speed. Therefore, I need to change the gear from second to third position. And moreover, as I told you, keep a tap on the sounds that come out of your car. Your engine might be telling you with the production of certain kind of sound that you need to change the gear. Or whenever you forget to change the gear and you speed up the car, the engine will certainly start making a certain noise. So you have to identify that, and quickly you have to change the gear. And similar kind of a thing happens when we drive at a lower speed on a higher gear, like fourth or fifth gear, and if we have reduced down the speed to somewhere between 40 to 50, again the car will begin shaking or you'll get a jerk. So it will give you an indication that you need to lower down the gear as well when you have reduced the speed. So these things are to be borne clearly in mind, and a better understanding will only come with more and more practice. As I have already told you in so many of my driving tutorial videos, that you need to practice a lot while you are learning to drive. So you have to do that. You cannot escape that part. Please practice as much as you can, such that you get an idea, okay, I'm driving at this particular speed. Without looking at the dashboard, your mind will tell you, you are driving at this particular speed. Okay, this much must be the speed when I'm I feel like this much must be the speed. So this kind of understanding requires to be developed, and you'll gain perfection in changing the gears from 1 to 2 to 3 to 4 to 5, and from 5 to 4 to 3 to 2 to 1. So this is very much important, and actually the most important part of driving. Therefore, the perfection in gear change and when to change the gears is very much important. So from this video, you have learned like when to change the gear, and from my previous driving tutorial video, you can learn how to change the gear smoothly. And I have also I have multiple driving tutorial videos in my driving tutorial playlist on my channel. So any of you who wishes to learn more about driving, you can visit my channel's playlist and you can see all those driving tutorial videos. They will definitely come to your help. And this is it for today. I wanted to tell you one more thing. Please do not be scared of driving. Driving is easy. It is very interesting. And once you'll have perfection, you'll fall in love with driving for sure. And moreover, please do not be scared of the technicalities. Okay, what is RPM now? How much should be the speed? And when should I change the gear? You will slowly and gradually everything you will understand. And, you know, just by listening to various people speaking so many things about the technicalities of driving, people get confused. People get nervous. They think like, oh my God, there is so much in this. And will I be able to learn it or not? Will I be able to grasp so many things or not? But trust me, there are not so many things. There are a few things which you need to understand properly. And once you understand them, you will be able to drive properly. And as and when you start practicing, you will understand those things even more properly and perfectly. Because, you know, practical is very much important. And once you carry forward the practical, the theory is clear. And when you study the theory, the practical is clear. So both are interdependent. So yeah, keep practicing and keep driving. You will gain mastery and perfection, I'm sure. And I'll be coming up with more interesting driving tutorial videos further. And this is it for today's video. I'll see you in my next video. If you have any other video suggestions, any queries, confusions, questions, please post that in the comment section. I'll look into it. And if you are new to my channel, then please make sure to subscribe and do not forget to hit the bell icon to be notified any further. If you genuinely like today's video, hit a like, share it with your friends, and I'll see you in my next video. Till then, stay tuned, keep watching, keep smiling, keep driving and practicing. Bye-bye. Take care.